Hi, I'm Patrick Murphy. I'm the lead designer with Trig Innovation. And part of working with a cutting-edge design firm is that we're constantly searching for new tools to streamline our design process and help our clients further collaborate with us during our projects. When I open up eDrawings, the first thing I'm going to see are these libraries of different models. There's sample ones that come with the software. There's also user files that you can add yourself. The only one I have in here is a model of a trash can. So when I click on that to open it, I see the trash can here. This is the main viewing screen of the eDrawing software. Right off the bat, I can go ahead and start manipulating this model. I can use one finger to touch and drag, and it's going to orbit around the model so I can see kind of every angle of it. I can also use two fingers pressed simultaneously to pan the model wherever I want to position it. And as with anything on a tablet, I can zoom in very intuitively, very fluidly, and use my two fingers to kind of push and pull the model to zoom into an area I want to see in greater detail. And at any point, I can hit this second tool down in the left-hand tab that has the little picture of the house. That's the home button, and it's going to bring me back to the very first view that I saw in the software. You'll see off to the right-hand side of the screen here these numbers, and these numbers correspond to different components of the overall unit. And when I hit them, they highlight that certain component. So if I'm sharing this with somebody else, if I'm talking to that specific part, I can tap one of these numbers and it'll take me through and highlight the various components that I want to talk to. Over on the left-hand tab here, this is where some of the more in-depth viewing tools lie. If I hit this first one here, the triangle play button, it's going to take me through a simple animation that very quickly shows me all of the orthographic, isometric, and 3D views of the unit, so I can really get a sense of what the design is like all around. And I can stop the animation at any point in time by just tapping once on the screen, and it's going to pause wherever I tapped, whatever view that was in. Another neat tool on the left-hand tab, it's this little cube icon with two arrows. This is where I can actually select any one of these orthographic views to look at. So I can go to my left-hand orthographic view, right, top, bottom, front. One of my favorite tools featured under this tab is the perspective view. If I tap that, it's going to make the viewport in perspective. And this is really nice because it provides you a view more similar to what this item is going to look like in real life, as if you were viewing it with your own eyes or you took a picture of it. And the second tool in from the left on this menu is the Hide Show tool. Once I have it enabled, I can tap a component to hide it, and it's going to make it disappear from the screen. And what this allows me to do is hide certain components so I can see kind of the geometry that may lie behind them. If I want to also focus on just a certain collection of components, I can hide the ones I don't want to see, and that can help me better review the design. Now, to make components show up again, I just hit the first button on the left there, the Show All, and it makes all the components come back into view. Now, a tool that I like a little bit better than the Hide Show tool is the Transparent Solid tool. Let's say I hit the body of the trash can here. I can still see it, but it's now transparent, and so I can see through it, see all the geometry that's going on inside of it, and also see how it is interacting with other components without actually making it disappear. And this is a great way to see all of the internal details and just have a better picture of what is represented in the CAD data. And to make a material return to full opacity again and not be transparent, I just have the tool enabled and I tap it again and it makes it fully opaque. The last tool in this menu is the Isolate tool. If I enable that and let's say I tap the foot of the trash can, it acts a lot like the Hide Show tool, but it's going to hide every component except for the one that I select. So if I'm reviewing a design that has many components, this trash can of course only has three, but if I were reviewing something that had hundreds of components and wanted to just isolate, focus on, and review one of them, I could use the Isolate tool to very easily do that and just view that component. I'm going to hit Show All again to bring all of the components back into view. Now, one of the greatest things you can do with this software that helps you collaborate with your clients and collaborate with your designers is the ability to email files or images from the software. And so what I can do, let's say I want to take a close-up look at this foot. I'm going to zoom into the foot area here, and if I tap this little send-off icon, it gives me three options. So if I select email image, it brings up an email window. I can compose an email, send it back to a designer, send it to a client, and that way I can call out a specific area of the design I want to look at and review. So in summation, eDrawings is a great software for reviewing 3D CAD data and looking at models from various angles, but the true collaborative power of it lies in the ability to email off or save both 3D CAD data and images of specific parts of the model. It's a great piece of software. It has all the functionality a designer or engineer would expect from a 3D CAD viewing program, but it's also very intuitive to use, even for somebody who's never used a program like this, but still needs to see all the nuances of a design product.